In this video, I show how to solve equations that have variables in the exponent, and we do the following five problems. This is part 15 of Logarithms. I'm going to show you how to solve equations that have variables in the exponent by using logs. For number one, 4 to the x equals 8, in this particular problem, we can solve this without using logs because both 4 and 8 can be written as a power of 2. So as a reminder, we can write 4 as 2 squared, and that's to the x power, and 8 is 2 cubed, and that gives you 2 to the 2x equals 2 cubed, because remember we multiply these exponents, 2 times x. If you can write both sides with the same base, then the exponents are equal. So if 2x is 3, then x will be 3 halves. So that's how I can solve for x. But I have a problem over here with 4 to the x equals 80. First of all, 80 is not a power of some whole number, like 4. 4 is 2 squared, but there isn't such a thing for 80. Also, you cannot divide both sides by 4. Be very careful here, because this is 4 to the x. So we have to use another strategy. The strategy when you have a variable in the exponent is to take the log of both sides. Now you could take the natural log or the log base 10. I'm going to write natural log just because it's shorter to write. So I'm going to say, all right, I'm going to take the natural log of both sides. And if we do that, now that I've written it in log form, this exponent could go out in front. So I have x times the natural log of 4 equals the natural log of 80. Hopefully this looks familiar to you from the last video. And now we could just divide both sides by the natural log of 4. So x is going to be equal to the natural log of 80 divided by the natural log of 4. So that's the exact answer right here. Now if we want to approximate this, let's say to 4 decimal places, then what I need to do is use my calculator. So you have to take the natural log of 80 divided by the natural log of 4. Do not round until the end of the problem. And let's do that. You could use log or natural log on your calculator. And I have that it's approximately equal to 3.16. Now it says 0.96, so that's going to be 1.0 if you go to 4 decimal places. Okay, now let's see if that makes sense. Look back at the original problem. It says 4 to the x equals 80. And I'm saying x is 3.1610 approximately. Well, if x was 3, 4 cubed would be 64. But notice it's a little bit bigger than that. It's 3.1610. And again, this is an approximation. So we can check to see if our approximation is close. So let's just do 4 to the 3.161 on a calculator. And I get that that's approximately 80, because actually my calculator came out with 004. So pretty close to 80, so this would be the approximation. You could have also done number one using the same method, but it's actually easier to do it without a calculator, I think, just these four steps. But if you want, you could take the log of both sides, pull the x out in front, just like we did for number two, and so that's something you could try on your own and see if you still get the same answer, which is 3/2. On your calculator, it'll show up as 1.5. Put the video on pause and try this problem. It's 5 to the 2x equals 35. Okay, there's actually a couple ways you could do this. We could just take the log of both sides to begin with, and let's just do natural log. You could use log or natural log. Oops, 35. We're going to pull out the 2x. Now, you got to be careful. 2x times the natural log of 5. I'm putting a parenthesis around there so you think of this as just a number. equals the natural log of 35. So if I was going to divide by, if I was going to solve for x, I could first just divide by natural log of 5 and then divide by 2, or I could just all at once divide both sides by natural log of 5. 2 natural log of 5, sorry. Now here's the interesting part. For 2 natural log of 5, you can either do 2 natural log of 5, or you could put the 2 back up on that 5 and then do the natural log of 25. So it doesn't matter which way you do this in your calculator, but this will also work. Natural log of 35 over the natural log of 25. In fact, at this step here, you could have written that as natural log of 25 to the x equals the natural log of 35. If you're comfortable with your, you know, laws of exponents, you start seeing more than one way to solve problems. But in any case, no matter which way you do it, this is the answer you should have gotten to 4 decimal places on your calculator. 1.1045. And again, you can check this by putting 1.1045 in for x in the original problem, multiply it by 2, do 5 to that number, and see if it gets close to 35. You can also use log base 10 and make sure you get the same answer. Sometimes people don't trust their calculator, which is a good thing, and so if you do it 2 ways and you still get the same answer, you should be all right. Okay, let's go on to a different type. Before doing this problem, remember this property of logs. Log base b of b to the m is simply m. All right, so here's our problem. E to the x equals 20. We take the log base 10 of both sides, or the log base e, natural log of both sides. Since this has a base e, it makes sense to take the natural log. So we have natural log of e to the x equals the natural log of 20, and then this is simply what? If you have natural log of e to the x, well, remember, that means log base e of e to the x, that's just going to be the number x, the letter x. So this is, x is just the natural log of 20. That's the exact answer. So if the base is e, make sure you take the natural log of both sides. Now if we want to approximate that, we put that in the calculator, and going to 4 decimal points, we get 2.9957, and let's do a quick little check. What is e to the 2.9957? It's 19.999. Yeah, it's about 20. So, looks like we've got the right answer here. All right, let's do another one. All right, 10 to the 2x minus 3 equals 48. Again, the variable is in the exponent, so we want to take the log of both sides. The question is, do we want to take the log base 10 or log base e, the natural log? Usually, it doesn't matter which one you take, but in this case, since the base is 10, we may as well take log base 10. So we've got the log of 10 to the 2x minus 3 equals the log of 48. And now, just like in the previous example, since the base is 10, this simply equals 2x minus 3. On the left-hand side, equals the log of 48. And now, we can finish solving for x by adding 3 and dividing by 2. So let's do that. First, we'll add 3. So I'm going to write this as 3 plus log of 48. And then we'll divide both sides by 2. And this is our exact answer for x. Last thing to do would be to use your calculator to estimate it to 4 decimal places. And estimating, I get 2.3406. You have to be very careful of order operations. You need to do the log of 48, then add 3, and then divide the whole thing by 2. And I'm going to leave the check to you. You could put 2.3406 back into this original equation and see if, when if you do 10 to the 2x minus 3, it's approximately 48.